The Voyage at Holiday World is one of the best roller coasters in the whole world. This wood coaster is a statistical monster. Voyage is the fifth tallest wood coaster in the world, standing 159 feet tall, or 48.5 meters tall. It's also the seventh fastest wooden coaster, reaching speeds of 67 miles per hour, or 108 kilometers per hour. And it's the second longest wood coaster, and the eighth longest overall coaster, at 6,442 feet, or 1,963.5 meters. This coaster is just 1,000 feet shorter than the Beast, but it does it all with just one lift hill. And Voyage is always doing something over that entire track length. I think the most amazing record that Voyage has is that it offers a whopping 24.3 seconds of airtime, the most of any wood coaster. With stats like this, it is no surprise that Voyage is a perennial contender for the best wooden coaster in the world. The coaster grabbed the top spot on Amusement Today's Golden Ticket Awards from 2007 to 2011, and it has finished no lower than fourth ever since it opened. Voyage also places very highly in other coaster polls like the Mitch Hawker poll, and it was built by the Gravity Group. And you may not realize this, but this was the second coaster Gravity Group ever built after Mount Olympus's Hades. So Gravity Group had an ambitious start, going big with Hades, and even bigger with Voyage. And it's very well possible we will never see another traditional wood coaster of this scale ever built. Voyage ran better than ever in 2020, and it's in no small part thanks to the amazing maintenance staff at Holiday World. The park has amazing dedication to keep their star attraction running in tip-top shape. I don't know how many parks could keep Voyage running as smoothly as it does. Voyage cost $8.5 million to construct, but Holiday World has to retract large sections of the ride almost annually. Voyage actually had to close early for the 2019 season so Holiday World could get a head start in maintenance. During the 2019-2020 off-season, Holiday World replaced 600 feet of track, and that's not the first time they've rebuilt entire sections of this ride. Some have been rebuilt several times. So while Voyage cost $8.5 million to originally build, the total cost of this coaster keeps increasing as Holiday World continually retracts it. In an attempt to reduce these maintenance costs and offer guests a smoother ride, Holiday World did investigate adding Gravity Group's Timberliner trains. Voyage originally opened with 3 7-car Philadelphia Toboggan Company trains. In 2009, Holiday World announced Voyage would be the first coaster to receive the Timberliner trains. Holiday World preemptively sold 2 of Voyage's trains to Darien Lake, where they would run on Predator. But when the Timberliner trains were delayed for the 2010 season, Holiday World only had 1 train available, which was inadequate for their premier attraction. So Holiday World transferred one of the Raven trains to Voyage for the 2010 season, giving them 2 trains. Holiday World continued testing the Timberliners from 2011 to 2013, but eventually, they decided to abandon the Timberliner project. The belief is that the Timberliner trains worsened the ride's dynamics and slowed the coaster down. If you want evidence of this, look at the conversion from Hades to Hades 360. That coaster originally opened with PTC trains, much like Voyage. When the coaster was transformed into Hades 360 for the 2013 season, the coaster not only received a barrel roll, but it also received Timberliner trains. Because these trains had less weight and less momentum, the park would not dispatch the train without anything less than a full train. And in future seasons, they reprofiled sections of the ride to mitigate the risk of valleying, most notably during the climb out of the underground tunnel on the return run. But back to Voyage. From the 2014 season onward, Voyage has run with 2 6-car trains. The back car was removed as a way to slightly reduce track wear without dramatically changing the overall ride experience. The other mitigation that Holiday World uses to reduce track wear is the mid-course trim. This trim brings the train to a near stop before the return run. Thankfully, Voyage does regain all that speed back relatively quickly, but the triple down is severely neutered with the trim active. However, you can experience Voyage without the trim. Occasionally, it will be off for early morning rides, but you can't guarantee this. If you want to guarantee yourself trimless rides, you can attend HoliWood Nights, the best roller coaster enthusiast event in my opinion. At this annual event, the park disables the mid-course trim, so Voyage doesn't slow down before the second half. Now, this may be an unpopular opinion, but I don't think disabling the mid-course radically changes the ride, at least not for me. The only element that feels different to me is the triple down if you're riding in the back. Everything else feels identical and completely out of control. What makes the bigger difference for me at HoliWood Nights is the availability of night rides. Holiday World often closes before sundown, so it can be very tricky to get night rides. Your best opportunity is to go on a summer Saturday night, but you'll have to cope with some of the busiest days of the year. Plus, Holiday World will close this line early if it backs up, so the last train of the night goes out right at the official park closing time. Because HoliWood Nights runs until 11 or 12 at night, you have ample time to get night rides and Voyage. And the fact it's running Trimless is just gravy. Plus, the energy and excitement from the other enthusiasts at the event is infectious. I cannot recommend HoliWood Nights enough. Voyage is located in the Thanksgiving section of Holiday World, and this area opened in 2006 with the coaster itself. And the entrance to this land is dominated by Voyage's humble-looking station and the imposing lift hill. As the name suggests, Voyage is themed to the journey the pilgrims undertook on the Mayflower to come to America. And the journey was anything but easy, so it's a very fitting name for such an aggressive coaster like the Voyage. Most of the time I've been at Holiday World, Voyage has been a 20 to 30 minute wait at worst, and that includes some visits on Memorial and Labor Day weekends. Honestly, the line tends to be longest at HoliWood Nights because all the roller coaster enthusiasts flock to this coaster. In terms of seat selection, I do have a slight preference for the front in Voyage, so you can get that extra rush of wind in your face. And the back is pretty good too for that first drop and the triple down if it's running untrimmed. But Voyage is one of those coasters where seat selection isn't as critical. For the most part, Voyage runs fairly similarly regardless of where you're sitting. And that's a characteristic I really admire about it. The airtime and sense of speed is fantastic in every row, and that really helped in 2020 when you could not pick your row. Voyage has the standard PTC individual ratcheting lap bars. The ones in Voyage seem to have a really low final position, so it is very easy to get stapled if you aren't careful. I recommend holding onto the lap bar to prevent it from lowering any further once the operators check it. And the operators usually avoid stacking Voyage. Now, that's mostly because Voyage is such a long ride, but the staff at Holiday World is super friendly and quite efficient. Voyage did occasionally run with three trains when it opened, but now it only runs with two at most. Voyage begins with a 159-foot tall lift. And really, Voyage can be broken down into three distinct sections. First, you have the outward leg, which rides like a hypercoaster. Second, you have the spaghetti bowl section, which rides like a twister. Third, you have the return run, which feels like an out-and-back wood coaster on steroids. Voyage begins with an excellent 154-foot first drop, and it's extremely steep too, with an angle of descent of 66 degrees. In fact, it's the steepest first drop on a traditional wooden coaster. And the airtime in this drop is outstanding if you're in the back. You are catapulted into your lap bar, and the airtime is very strong and sustained. It's one of the best wooden coaster drops out there because of the sheer size and that airtime. That's followed by a giant 107-foot tall camelback that offers some great floater airtime all throughout the train. That's followed by another sizable camelback, this one being 100 feet tall, except this one has a twist to it. Literally. This hill subtly twists to the left at the top, so not only do you get airtime in this hill, but you also get some great laterals at the same time. And those won't be the last laterals you get in this ride, that's for sure. If you're towards the front, this camelback offers a strong pop of airtime. Towards the back, the airtime is more sustained and of the floater variety on the drop. And the third hill drops into the first of many tunnels. The exact number of tunnels on Voyage depends if you double count the tunnels that the ride passes through twice on both the outward and return legs. But to me, I count each separate instance you go in and out of a tunnel, so I consider Voyage to have 7 tunnels. When you emerge, you find yourself flying over this speed hill that gives good sustained floater airtime throughout the entire train. It also has a slight twist to the right atop this hill, so you get some mild laterals as well. You then dive back underground briefly, and when you emerge, you crest the fifth hill. And this camelback offers great floater airtime throughout the train yet again. You then dive back underground, and when you emerge, you find yourself navigating Voyage's spaghetti bowl. And this section is pure chaos. It feels completely out of control. Well, the whole ride feels out of control, but this section in particular does. and that's especially true at night when you can't see any of the transitions or changes of direction. The turnaround consists of small dips giving abrupt pops of airtime, and several turns offering solid laterals. The entire section is a blur. This spaghetti bowl starts with this drawn-out S-hill, but since you fly over it, you get an aggressive pop of airtime combined with some faint laterals. That's followed by another quick dip that offers another very strong pop of airtime. The back-to-back S-hill and dip sort of feels like a double down. This leads into this high-speed, low turnaround that offers some nice sustained laterals. That then leads into a double down of sorts, consisting of two quick dips in rapid-fire succession. Each also gives an aggressive pop of airtime. Voyage then carves its way around two 90-degree turns. The second in particular is really tight, and it can cause the train to shuffle quite a bit, especially if it's been a while since it was retracked. These turns don't offer much in terms of laterals, but it's quite disorienting having two 90-degree turns back-to-back in opposite directions. Voyage then zips over this little dip, giving everyone a quick pop of airtime. You then dive into the fourth tunnel, which contains another small dip, giving everyone another pop of airtime. You then rise up into the mid-course, and if you're up front, you get a little pop of airtime here. But it sort of feels like Voyage barely makes it up into the mid-course. But don't worry, this is the only part of Voyage where you get a chance to catch your breath. You see, the entire first half of Voyage climbs a hill. This is the same hill you have to walk up to get to Thunderbird from Voyage. But that hill doesn't stop at Thunderbird. It keeps going. This elevation change can be a bit hard to tell when you're actually riding Voyage because of how fast it's going and the scale of the hills in the first half. But it is sneakily climbing that hill. And then the entire spaghetti bowl section takes place atop that hill. So the big question is, how tall is this hill? Google Earth estimates the elevation change from Voyage's station to the top of this hill is roughly 29 meters or 95 feet. That's 15 feet taller than Raven and only 4 feet smaller than the Legend. This allows Voyage to have the same kinetic energy of a traditional wood coaster for the entire return run because it's all downhill back to that station. And you just keep building up more and more speed the whole way down. The return run kicks things off with a triple down in the ride's fifth tunnel. If Voyage is running trimmed, you don't get any airtime here. But if Voyage is running trimless, the second and third drops of the triple down have really strong airtime in the back. As I mentioned earlier, this is the lone element that feels radically different to me, at least, when Voyage is running trimmed versus untrimmed. Either way, Voyage regains all its speed when it re-emerges into the daylight, and you fly over back-to-back bunny hills, offering sustained floater airtime throughout the whole train. That's followed by this bizarrely twisted hill that I'm going to call the Squiggle Hill. It starts off like your standard S-hill, twisting up and to the left. But the descent sort of feels like Trick Track because it starts banking to the right, before starting to bank back to the left, before deciding to bank to the right yet again. The apex of this hill gives a strong pop of airtime, and you get some mild laterals from the banking. You then twist up into a bunny hill, getting some laterals on the way up, and good floater airtime over the top of the hill. That's followed by a series of turns that intersect the lift structure a few times. You don't get any airtime in these turns, but quite a few of them offer real nice laterals. You then rocket over back-to-back S-hills. The first crosses over the pre-lift and then dives under the station. The second charges over the brake run before diving under the midway. And both these S-hills offer a delightful combination of laterals with a very strong pop of airtime. The exit from the final tunnel offers another very strong pop of airtime. You then twist up into the brake run, ending one of the most aggressive and relentless coasters in the world. From the top of the lift hill to the final brake run, Voyage is roughly 1 minute and 45 seconds in length. That is insanely long for a coaster that only has one lift, and travels as fast as Voyage does through the whole course. The last thing I want to touch on is the ride's smoothness. I have never had an issue with Voyage. And it doesn't matter if I'm riding in a wheel seat or a non-wheel seat. Voyage is not rough, to me at least. I'd consider Voyage to be aggressive. It feels completely unhinged and out of control. It will throw you around with all the airtime and laterals, and you have some of the shuffles you'd expect from a wood coaster, but all things considered, the track work on this coaster is incredible considering what it does. Kudos again to Holiday World for keeping this monster running as well as they do. So what would I rate Voyage? This coaster is absolute perfection, and I'm giving it a perfect 10 out of 10 rating. This coaster does a little bit of everything, It has an amazing first drop and jumbo camelbacks reminiscent of a hypercoaster on the outward leg. The spaghetti bowl section feels like an unhinged twister, mixing in laterals and airtime in perfect unison. And the return run is a berserk blitz of airtime and laterals. The fact you're always doing something in Voyage and traveling so fast on such a long ride is why it's one of my favorite coasters. The pacing is incredible. Very few coasters are better paced. And on that note, Voyage may very well be my favorite roller coaster. Ever since I rode Lightning Rod in 2017, that has been my favorite roller coaster. That coaster's relentlessness, powerful airtime, and setting made it my dream coaster. Voyage matches Lightning Rod in the aggressiveness and pacing department. It also has an equally as amazing setting that offers incredible night rides as well. It just comes down to whether I prefer the superior quality of each of Lightning Rod's elements or the sheer length of Voyage. And it's really hard for me to say. What I can say for sure is that Voyage is one of the best two coasters I have ever ridden, and it's an elite, one-of-a-kind coaster that absolutely needs to be experienced, and I cherish every single one of my rides I get on this coaster. So those are my thoughts on Voyage, the legendary coaster at Holiday World. What are your thoughts on Voyage? Please let me know what you think of this ride down in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, I'd appreciate if you gave it a like and considered subscribing, because there'll be a lot more roller coaster and amusement park videos here at Canopy Coaster. Thanks for watching.